Daniel 7 and 25. I see they try to take the Sabbath from me. They took me from Jerusalem and try to Babylon me. They put me in through slavery and put a paddle on me. But now it's wartime, I got the Bible on me. Fire coming, it's getting ready for Esau. But he don't want no beef, he like a meat raw. Prophecy, captivity for my enemies. I'm from the tribe of Judah, so check the pedigree. Yeah, and me and Christ look a lot alike. 144 shining, that's a lot of lights. He also said we'll be hated for his sake. So if we had an Instagram, we wouldn't get a lot of lights. Shining, glowing, gleaming forever, man. Keeping the laws and the faith is the better plan. Yeah, if the commandment is a lamp, then tell me, who the hell is Thomas Edison? Shining, ever since I put my fringes on, I've been shining. Ever since I let all my sins go, shining. Now I'm my brother's keeper, and we shining. Shining, 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 shining. We gon' let this whole world blow. We gon' let this whole world know. We the light of this world, so.
I got a question about Deuteronomy 27:16.
Deuteronomy chapter 27 and verse 16. Cursed be he that setteth light by his father or his mother, and all the people shall say amen. All
right, go to Matthew. Matthew 15, here we go, this is what we talk about. Start with one. Matthew 15 is that infamous chapter that Christianity uses to say you can eat whatever you want to. You just read the beginning of the chapter, you know what he's talking about. Read that.
Matthew chapter 15, verse 1. Then came to Jesus scribes and Pharisees, which were of Jerusalem, saying, why do thy disciples transgress the traditions of our elders?
Traditions
of our elders. For they wash out their hands when they eat bread.
So the subject matter of chapter 15 is talking about eating with unwashed hands. Not that you can eat whatever you want to. Read on.
But he answered and said unto them, why do ye also transgress the commandment of God by your tradition?
Go ahead.
For God commanded, saying, honor thy father and mother, and he that curses father or mother, let him die the death.
All right, so show of hands, anybody ever? We just read in Deuteronomy 27:16 where it said, cursed be he that sendeth light by his mother or his father. Flip to the New Testament where it says, where Christ said, God commanded, honor thy father and mother, and he that curses father and mother, let him die the death. How does that correlate?
Matthew chapter 15 and verse 4. For God commanded, saying, honor thy father and mother.
So the commandment is honor your father and your mother. Right? That's the commandment. That's the foundation of it. That's the commandment from the jump. Honor your father and your mother. Who got kids? By a show of hands in here. Who got kids? Raise your hands. Okay. All right. So now we're going to use some common sense when we read the Bible. The Bible ain't deep. It has deep parts, but it's basic. It's straightforward. God knows how we are. So, when your son or your daughter stops listening to what the hell you're telling them, what is the reason that now they starting to, what'd you say, they starting to feel themselves? They start to smell themselves. Oh, okay. What would be that reason? Aaron, you got your hand up. Let's be quick with the mic. Let's see.
They no longer fear their parents, so they're all set for
them. There you go! That's all he said. God said, curse him, put him to death. They lost, that's what it says. Go back to Deuteronomy 27:16.
Deuteronomy chapter 27 and verse 16. Cursed be he that setteth light by his father or his mother.
No longer respects his mother or his father. Read on.
And all the people shall say amen.
Now give me the one, I think it's what, Deuteronomy, the rebellious son. Deuteronomy chapter 21 and verse 18. Read that, 21 and 18 on down.
Deuteronomy chapter 21 and verse 18.
Here's another precept for him.
If a man have a stubborn and rebellious son, which would not obey the voice of his father or the voice of his mother, and that when they have chastened him would not hearken unto them, then shall his father and his mother lay hold on him, and bring him out unto the elders of his city, and unto the gate of his place. And they shall say unto the elders of his city, this our son is stubborn and rebellious.
This is our son who has made light of us being his parents. He don't think nothing of us no more. He's smelling himself. He is stubborn and rebellious. That's what, you know, the term we use. He's smelling himself, he's feeling himself. Reality is, your kids are stubborn and rebellious. That's what's really going on when they start to become teenagers and things of that nature, and they wanna think they got their own mind to do what they want to do. They basically stubborn and rebellious. When we was under the law of animal sacrifice, when the judgment for things was death, God gave you the judgment for a lot of these kids won't be alive today. A lot of these kids in your high schools today, the rabbi can be like, dang, all praises for Jesus. A lot of these kids would not be alive today because the law then was stubborn and rebellious kids. Read that verse 20 again.
That was it.
Deuteronomy chapter 21, verse 20. And they shall say unto the elders of his city, this our son is stubborn and rebellious. He would not obey our voice. He is a glutton and a drunkard.
He has made light of us being his parents. He don't respect us no more. Read on.
And all the men of his city shall stone him with stone.
Put his ass to death, God said.
That he die.
That he die. Go to Deuteronomy 27, 16 now. God complained about their respect when it comes to kids and their parents. Because why does he not play about that when it comes to kids respecting their parents? Let's see. Naeem. Let's see why. Hold on, turn. Leave the microphone on.
Because they don't respect the parents, you don't respect the Most High.
Right. And we are the Most High's kids.
That's right.
So he knows all about when it comes to respect. He ain't playing that stuff. So he put it, when we was under the law of life and death, under the sacrifice, when we was in our own land, basically, and we ruled ourselves. All right, Deuteronomy 27, 16. Yeah.
Deuteronomy chapter 27 and verse 16.
Huh?
Cursed be he that setteth light by his father or his mother.
That does not respect his parents anymore. Read on.
And all the people shall say amen.
All the people. God wanted all the people of Israel to agree to this thing so you wouldn't turn like you do today. You see somebody's bad kids, not us, because they're here. I'm checking everybody's kids. Everybody. Those are my kids too. So, but in the world, you see it a lot. You see people, you see the most bad kids just, a lot of y'all that work with kids now, you be stressed at your jobs now because you come in here. And our kids is kids because the scriptures say foolishness is bound in a child. But the kids in here, they know it's a certain level to where the badness got to cut off or they going to get their ass yanked up by somebody. They got 300 pairs of eyes on them. Wherever they go, they can't slack off nowhere. Somebody's always correcting them. But in the world, you know, people have come to the thing, don't you teach me how to raise my kids. Mm. So now you to the point to where they send them kids to y'all be like, Lord, please, I wish I had another job. Oh, Lord, I wish I had another job. These kids is bad. Because you used to deal with
some righteous kids that get corrected at every step of the way. You're dealing with my righteous kids in the world. The law was back then, we put the kids to death. Wasn't no turning the blind eye in Israel when we was in our own land. That's why God said, and all the people shall say amen. That means you agree to this. When you see a stubborn and a rebellious kid out here with these running the streets, y'all take his ass and you take him to the elders of the city. Everybody get a stone, get a rock.
Ooh, a child.
Get a child. Get a rock, throw him into a pit, and everybody stand there and wail off on him. God was playing. So, it's going to come a time again. It'll come to that time again. I'll go to that scripture here in a second. It's going to come to that time again. All of us, so you kids, you are under grace to get it right. I'll tell you right now, you're under grace. Go to Ephesians 6 and 1. Where's the one in Peter 2? About the parents. Go to Ephesians. Give me the one in Peter, but go to Ephesians 6 and 1 first.
Ephesians.
It's my Ephesians. There we go.
Chapter 6 and verse 1. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right.
For this is right in the eyesight of the Lord. Children, obey your parents. And I pray your kids are taking heed to this thing, and you don't get to the point where you become rebellious and stubborn. The white man tells you, I'm of age now. How old you gotta be to drink liquor? How old is it?
21.
You'll be 21? Okay, 21 to drink, and then
for cigarettes.
How's it to go in Esau's army?
18,
right? So basically
17, if your mama sign off on you.
Oh. So 17, 18 year olds are going to Esau's army, you know, America tells you, okay, now you grown. You get out of high school, go to college, you grown, whatever, all of that type of stuff. And then you start being stubborn and rebellious. But God says to obey your parents is right in the Lord. I pray that you kids, listen to my voice now, don't get to the point to where you think you've grown in your own mind, and then, okay, I can make my own choices. Mama, I don't want to do this stuff no more. I'm great going out there in the world. And we've had brothers and sisters in this truth. When their kids got of age, the moment they was able to move out the house, they went back into wickedness, put on pants, went to the club, being whores and whore mothers. I pray that ain't y'all spirit in here. But read verse 1 again.
Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 1.
Go ahead.
Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with thee, and thou mayest live long on this earth.
That's why God tells, it's the next verse that I got. That's why God tells you to obey your parents so that you may live long. Now you kids ain't, you ain't sitting, you see what's going on in the news. You see, what's that dude, Stephon Clark? He was 20 something years old, hell, even younger than that. Trayvon Martin, Mike Brown was 18 years old, I think he was. It's countless. Who was the one that? Tamir Clark, right?
Tamir Rice.
Including Tamir Rice. He was what, 11 or 12 years old? He was 11 or 12 years old, out there playing in the streets. God tells you, obey your parents for a reason, because out of you obeying what they tell you to do comes long life. You don't obey your parents, death is waiting on you, especially as a young black man, young Hispanic man. They gonna be quick to pull that trick, because one thing you ain't learned, you ain't listen to your parents, you ain't learn how to respect people. And then you think that you get pulled over, you got that music in your ear, you're high on some weed, and your boys in the car, you puffed up, and a cop pull you over, and you move too quick. They got the family trigger for you. Obey your parents in the Lord, meaning keeping the commandments. Now read verse 4.
And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath.
Does anybody have any idea? Take a shot at it. What does that mean? Provoke not your children to wrath. Does anybody know what that means? Where's that scripture at? It might be Ephesians 2. Oh, Abel, got your hand up. I see you back there, son. We're not cutting you things.
Shalom, Bishop. It means...
Voice of Christ. Oh, go ahead.
yeah, it means to neither get home. I'm sorry.
Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 4. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath.
Meaning provoke them not to fall into wrath of the Most High.
There you go. Exactly right. Don't provoke them to wrath by not being a parent to them and teaching them. Newsflash, for you women, mainly the women, you are not your daughter's friend.
Bring it up.
Brothers, you are not your son's homeboy. No, not at all. You are their father and their mother. To hell with friends. You know what? You know what a true friend is? What did Christ say in Matthew? Let's see if we can find that. Hold on. Let's see. I'll show you what a true friend is in the Bible. John. Let's go to John. John chapter 15, let's start at verse 14. Yeah, verse 14. That's what I want.
John chapter 15 and verse 14. Ye are my friends.
You are what?
Ye are my friends.
You parents want to be a friend to your children. You just can't bear to tell them right from wrong. Read.
If ye do whatsoever I command you.
That's a true friend in the eyes of Jesus the Christ. You want to be your child's friend, they need to be doing what you command them to do, and you're supposed to be teaching them the commandments of God so you don't provoke them to God's wrath. God's wrath? I know we be thinking far off. God's wrath is the second coming of Christ. All God's wrath is when your son ends up on a t-shirt. That's God's wrath.
Rest
the R.I.P. That's you on the news. It was Stephon Clark's mother. She had it was an interview. She was crying. She was talking about she wanted justice and stuff. You know, the son is just a memory now. That's the wrath of God. Now, I don't know. You know, if the brother was innocent or not. Said a reported burglary or in cars. You know, kind of. You know, we as judges, we see the whole matter. You know, really ain't no reason to run from a cop if you ain't in trouble in the first place.
Right.
I'm looking at the video. I'm not saying it's right for they reeled off 20 shots at the brother in his back. I'm not saying that at all. But you don't run from cops unless you're in trouble or you're guilty about something. So, yeah, you know, it's the wrath of God, though. It came for him. And it found him. So, you parents, don't be friends. Command them kids what to do in the eyes of the Lord and let them not be provoked to the wrath of God. Read verse 4 again.
You got something? Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 4. And ye fathers, provoke not your children to wrath, but bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord.
So look at this. Don't you pay attention? Everybody got to pay attention to the details. You, all of y'all there, raise your hand and said you got kids, right? Guess who the Lord didn't pass the buck on to warn your kids and teach them? Who did he not pass the buck to?
Then
y'all reading the same Bible I am. Isaac, can you please stand up and tell us who God did not pass the buck to warn the kids, to raise them in the nurture and admonition, the warning of the Lord?
Shalom. He didn't pass the buck on you. It's for you.
So who? He's speaking Spanish.
Where are those sisters? Esau.
No. You missed it. Solomon, let's see. Who did he not pass it off to?
The Lord didn't pass it to the mothers.
He didn't pass it to the mothers.
Hey, you going on
romantic. Yeah, I'm going to throw you the door. So you men can't be lazy. Go to your mama.
Right.
You know how many times I've been hearing that out of you brothers? With kids? I ain't going to point no fingers because the Lord hated the point of the fingers.
Bring it out.
But I'm just scared. And you know who we are. He didn't pass it off to the women. He said, fathers, it's your job to do it.
Bring it out.
That's why, no slight at you women. And I know some of y'all coming from This ain't even today's class, it's just a question of hey, ladies, all praises to Most High, we back together again. I just... y'all pray for us. But I know a lot of y'all women coming out, you single mothers and into that nature, and even with your husbands, you was used to leading the way, and you know, it really wasn't 50-50, it was really like 80-20, but you gave him the illusion that it was 50-50, so you ain't gotta argue with him all the time.
That's true.
But a woman cannot teach a man how to be a man. You can raise him. You can raise him. When he's sick, you can give him some Tussin, Theraflu, you know, check on him in the middle of the night. You can do those things. That's the nurture that a man needs so he can learn some compassion. He needs that from a woman. But you can't teach him how to be a man, how to stand up strong, how to stop crying, how to speak loud. Look a man in his eye when he talks to you. Stand up for yourself. Don't let nobody do this to you. You can say all those things, but it don't hold the weight like it does from a man.
Right, right.
That's why God said in verse 4, you fathers, it's your job to do it. He listens to his mother, but he fears you. That's why you need to be in the household. That's why our kids are out. All right, I just do a little
hey, I'll bring it. Let me get some rocks out of the third. I posted something on, I think it was leadership, Denzel Washington said something. He said about the black man being caught in the system. And he said, the dude asked him, is it the police fault that the black man getting shot? He said, they don't lock up 2-year-olds. He said, man, they're not locking up at 5-year-old. They get to a certain age, and that's when they call in the system. That's because they ain't being taught at the house. He said they all lack fathers. He said he was one out of three. He had two best friends. Both of them went to prison. He said they in prison right now. None of them had their fathers. Denzel Washington said his father was in his life, and he turned out better than all his friends. It's a big difference. Read verse 9.
Sirach chapter 30 and verse 9. Conquer thy child.
What does conquer mean, bro? Amazon.
Conquer. Don't leave it.
She'll spoil it. Yeah, I want some different though. Right here.
Rule?
No. Hosea. Conquer. Conquer. What is it? I mean, spoil is good. But it's another word I'm looking for.
Pamper.
Give me another word. Always, give me another word. You changing the name yet, brother? Okay.
Play.
Conquer thy child, read.
Sirach chapter 30, verse 9. Conquer thy child, and you shall make thee afraid.
How can you plan with your child make you afraid? Who got kids in here? All the brothers, right. all the fathers, raise your hands.
Right.
Come on, man. Let me see. I'm about to call
some questions too.
Yeah, the common sense. We're basic. Hey, you changed your name. What's your name again, brother?
Natazar.
Natazar. Natazar.
He pronounced every syllable.
Natazar.
Natazar.
Three syllables. Natazar. It's been a while. Go ahead, brother. Read it for me.
Sirach chapter 30 and verse 9. Mm-hmm. Conquer thy child, and he shall make thee afraid.
How can playing with your child make you afraid?
Your child lose respect for you.
Lose respect. And what did he start doing?
He started
you up.
Yeah.
Now he's looking at you like, you the son. Now she looking at the mother like, you the daughter. And you see that happen rapid in our communities. That's why you see all the war star hip hop, the daughters fighting the mothers.
The mother's fighting the grandma.
It was a video that I think Bishop McDaniel posted. I don't know if y'all seen it. It was a daughter on the bus slapping her mom in the face. She had her by her hair and slapping her.
And I guarantee you, that mother used to play with her daughter.
And the father went in the house.
Now, it's not talking about you can't have a good time with your kids.
Right.
It's talking about when it comes to lay the law down, ain't no games. My kids know. Ain't no game. I give them that look. Ain't no game to play. Go ahead, officer. Give them a mic.
No, it's a saying that I have with my kids. I laugh and I joke, but I don't play.
Yeah, I don't play.
I laugh and I joke with you,
but I ain't. Hey, you know Judah say, I don't play the radio.
Yeah.
hey, Judah know that. I don't play the radio. Read on.
Sirach chapter 30, verse 9.
Watch this.
Conquer thy child, and he shall make thee afraid.
Uh-huh.
Play with him. And he will bring thee to heaven.
He shall bring in heaven. What nation is known for this? I'm going to say to y'all, thank you. What nation is known for playing with their kids and then their kids bring them to heaven? What nation? Amazon.
Israel.
Calm down. It's going to be all right. Damn, they like this, but you dropped the ball. He was on the road. What nation is known for playing with their kids, and their kids is known for bringing heaviness?
Esau.
I'm seeing some of y'all's kids control. I really want to ask white people. I've always been curious. Why don't y'all just beat your kids, man? Beat them. Whoop their ass. Y'all give y'all kids all kind of timeouts and special places. The fuck is a special place? To a black child, that's a coma. What is a special place? Black kids don't know shit about timeout. We know about getting knocked. That's it. My mother used to slap the me in public, and I would look at people for help.
Esau put their kids in timeout for slapping them in the face.
Go to your room.
For shooting a dog. Look,
Bill, I know you didn't mean that. It's okay. Go in timeout right now. And then the child get 22 and blow up the whole school. Come home because mom took away their whistle.
In Florida, where another community is in disbelief, shocked by devastating violence, this time at that Florida high school on Valentine's Day.
This image, one that has become all too familiar. Students evacuating with their hands up. The suspect in that deadly shooting is now in custody. New images this morning showing him being taken to jail. George is outside that school.
Esau put their kids in timeout for slapping them in the face.
Go to your room.
For shooting a dog.
Look, Bill, I know you didn't mean that. It's okay. Go in timeout right now. And then the child get 22 and blow up the whole school. Come home because mom took away their whistle.
I would have killed everybody.
Hey, all she did was take away the whistle. They get an AK-47, they kill their mama, their daddy, and then they go to grandma's, kill them. And then they go to elementary school, kill them, and they kill themselves.
And then let go.
Hey, but all she did, all that comes from, conquer thy child, he shall make thee afraid. The fear of God was never established. Because you being God in your house, man, when you discipline your kids, you put the fear of God in them. You gotta put the fear of God in them. That was gonna say, raise a child, train up a child as you go. When you get older, they want to part. That training is the fear of God.
Yep.
All right, so.
Let's go back to the original question. What does Deuteronomy 27
say? Been a while, man. Got a lot to say.
Deuteronomy 27:16. Well, we got the next question. Go ahead, read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 27 and verse 16. Cursed be he that setteth light by his father or his mother, and all the people shall say amen.
So that's what it's going into. Cursed be the son of darkness that does not respect his parents. Back then, he was getting put to death. Now, a lot of that, the kids being out of order, is due to our fault. So that's why Christ came. Now that's why he put you under the subjection of your enemies. If you don't train your kids in the admonition of the Lord and warn them, they'll be unruly, and then God will have Esau come and take them from you. Since you don't want to be the godly man or woman that you're supposed to be, they'll take them from you. So, all right, that's what Deuteronomy 27:16. That's the basics and the deep basics.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.